PowerDirector 16, is it possible to do a silhouette in PowerDirector 16? I'm going to show you that, and I'm going to use ColorDirector, which is another program that PowerDirector sells, on how to do a silhouette. Now, this works, but it's not the best way to do it. It really isn't. I mean, really, if you've got a green screen and you can set up your lighting and get that silhouette right off the bat, it's going to make it a lot easier. But if you had no choice and you had to do it through PowerDirector 16, let's have a look and see how I figured out how to do it. So basically, I'm going to Chrome key this really quick. And I have a video on that. I'll put a link so you can go check that out if you're Chroma keying. And I'm just flying through it pretty quick. Now what I'm going to do is go to Fix and Enhance. And then you're going to see up here at the top where ColorDirector is, where it actually runs that other program. Now ColorDirector has loaded it, and it's loaded up here. I'm actually going to click up here and just make the whole thing black and white to make this a little easier. Click the bullseye, and now what you're going to do is color your object in. Now, I would suggest when you make the video, if this is what you have to do, then try not to move your body too much around while making the video when you're trying to make this silhouette effect. It will make it a whole lot easier on you while you're doing it. But if you're moving all over the place, you might even find this kind of impossible to do. Okay, I think I got it. There we go. Down here, it's going to say start motion tracking, and it's going to track the motion of the particular object in the video. So I'm going to start tracking it. And then as it goes, you see the red lines around the subject. Now notice, I lost some of my ear there. I don't want to do that. I kind of want that covered up. And I'm pausing and stopping and running. And every now and then, I just take a quick look at it. Lost a little bit there again. See that? Continue again. And like I said, if you had a very long video and you were moving all over the place, this would take a very long time. See how I moved my head kind of sideways there? That's what I mean by not moving around very much. I got a point sticking out of my head there. And there's where my arms actually came into play. See that? I probably need to back that up. Now, I should have done this here, but the tracking's done. Let's so now I'll go back to the beginning. I'll play it through. It's not that bad, but you get the idea of what I'm trying to do there. Now, what am I going to do? Well, I'm going to go over here on the left, and I'm going to turn my exposure way down to the left. Notice that darkened me out. I'm going to turn my brightness way down. That almost took me out. Now I'm going to turn my contrast up, and I should get the shadow effect I want. And now I'm going to hit play. So if you tweak that and play with that a little bit more, and you'll see where that hand came up where I got to it later. And I'm leaving these mistakes in here so you can see what's going on. So that is how you make a silhouette in PowerDirector 16. And if you like reviews or survival, you might want to go check out my channel called Secret Stuff. I'll have a link in the bottom. I actually have a bunker tornado shelter where I live here in Tennessee. We actually get tornadoes every spring, and we do have people that die every year. So I decided to build myself a two-room tornado shelter, so it's something I don't have to worry about. My cameras I've purchased, which lenses I use, I do a lot of backpacking, I go hiking with my dog all the time, and I even threw together a cat shelter I built, and I'm horrible at woodworking. The thing is made like Fort Knox, but you can have a look at that if you want and hook up. If you've got a channel and you want me to advertise you, send me a private message and I'll hook you up. And anyhow, guys, I'll catch you later. Catch you on the next one.